This is the fourth year of the GridFree Solar Kit giveaway, and this is a great one. 2 years ago, this was just a paddock. Now, it's a piece of paradise. The only thing that was missing was a solar kit on the roof.
Guys, come here! We won! Yes! Yes! Oh my gosh, thank you.
We absolutely loved your story. We love the fact that you're embracing the grid-free lifestyle. We love the fact that you gather your own kai, that you're doing everything to truly live off the grid.
Oh my gosh!
I can't wait.
Come with me and meet Kayla and Paula. Let me introduce you to their piece of paradise.
Hello.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
Hello.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Kayla.
Hi.
How's it going, mate?
Nice to meet you in person.
Yeah.
Winning this grid-free solar system is going to make a huge difference in our lives. Kia ora, I'm Kayla.
Hi, I'm Paula.
And we are here in Tokomaru Bay, so welcome to our Papakāīnga.
Hi, my name's Kion.
Hi, I'm Nala, and we live off grid.
Amen.
Kia ora.
Well, I don't like the whole work is up.
We start with a karakia. It sets the foundation that everyone is safe. And whatever we do today, māma noiho. Everything's easy. It's just a simple welcome, karakia. Now let's get into it.
So we chose the off-grid lifestyle. We've always wanted to go off-grid. It's always been one of our goals. Bringing our babies back to the whenua, connecting with the whenua again, being able to teach them how to be self-sufficient, grow their own food. Like if we weren't around, we know that they can grow their own kai. And it's not just growing plants, they can grow from seed. Half of their fruit trees they've grown themselves from seeds. And be able to just gather them their own kai and living in a natural world, like bringing them up in a natural world where they have fresh kai. Their kai's got whakapapa.
Yeah.
They've grown it themselves, so yeah.
And just the freedom of being off grid is beautiful.
Having no stress. When we were in town, it was like, how are we going to pay bills? All of that stuff. So having none of those adult problems these days and just being able to live and be and connect, and like our kids have never been so grounded before.
And it gives us more time together.
Yeah.
More time. So this is our gardening rink.
Bit of mahi going in here, eh?
Yep. This is where we mostly grow our ones up here.
So what do you got? You got cabbages here?
Cabbage.
Sweet peas. Zucchinis, onions, some corn.
Oh, right. Yeah. This isn't your only garden though, eh?
You have
the tunnel house and everything else. Yep. But this produces enough for you? Yeah?
Oh,
yeah.
Plenty.
Last year, this was full of zucchinis and we didn't, couldn't keep up with it. We had to drop some off at the kai cupboard down here. We had to give it away. We preserved a lot.
Just goes to show, eh? You don't need much to produce a lot of food, eh?
No way. And it's quite cool too, because we've companion planted a lot other than the cabbages, which helps the plants be more healthier and bigger. And
I noticed some banana trees here.
Yes. We planted those last year with the kids.
So does each one of your children responsible for these?
Yes. Watering, feeding and weeding around them, and just giving it a bit of kinder juice here and there. And as you can see, they've kind of been keeping up with it.
Are they in competition to see who can produce the most bananas?
Yeah. Currently we got one solar up there and a couple of batteries in the house and a generator if we need be for the shower. And the challenges of that is we're one of the few that travel to pick up our food due to not having a powerful fridge freezer. And just the little things like kids watching TV or something are not able to do. So
having to entertain them on rainy days when you've got no power is like, my kids are not made for inside.
Definitely not.
So we came across a post on social media about the competition, and we've always wanted solar, but we've never had the money there to be able to purchase one. So we thought we'd enter, and yeah, we won. Winning this grid-free solar system is going to make a huge difference in our lives. We'll be able to run a fridge. We'll be able to run a freezer. That will definitely come in handy when we're doing our home cools, or, you know, even freezing our overflow of veggies.
Since we have solar, what I'm most excited about is having a toaster, not using the pan anymore, and finally being able to watch a full movie without it just cutting out halfway.
Having
not
ice cream.
Having ice cream,
ice blocks on a hot day.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we can get an ice cream machine and a cotton candy machine.
Oh yeah,
those are the
a
best.
A bigger fridge.
Cold drinks. We don't have to buy ice anymore.
Yeah, and just be able to give that Jenny a rest. That noise. Oh my gosh.
Running the Jenny is, it's terrible. Just to be able to sit down as a family and watch a movie or...
Help us run my sleep apnea machine and charge all our appliances.
And we don't have to travel into town.
Yep.
We don't have to fill up the generator anymore. We don't have to buy petrol anymore. And washing. Like, I'm so excited to do washing. I've never been this excited to do washing before.
So what was this like when you came here?
This was just hill. There was absolutely nothing on here. So we've planted all the fruit trees. We've done all the martyrs. We've done the building. Like, it was just a paddock. It was a blank canvas.
So the driveway, the flattening, the building, the clothesline, the tanks, all this in the last 2 years.
Yeah. There's been a lot of mahi that's been put into here. Really, the mahi never stops. My papa, he's built all of our houses. So he was a huge part of this. Really, our whole family's been a huge part of it. It's all been whānau that have had some sort of input into us being able to build our home. You don't need that much money to create something like this. Off-grid living to us means more time with our babies, being able to homeschool our kids, and, you know, if the tide's right, we get to go out for a dive, or, you know, we're here on the whenua planting and bringing the whenua back to life. That was one of our huge goals. When we moved on here, we had no bird life, so seeing the birds come back, we got kittadoos, we got tuis coming back and fantails, so having the bird life coming back to life is pretty cool.
Now that we live off grid, our costs are lower.
We don't have a $500 monthly power bill. Growing our own food saves us a lot as well, especially being a family of six. So we don't buy veggies, we don't buy meat. We do all of our own meat, process our own meat. We have our own eggs. Like, you know, we're pretty self-sufficient. If we do go to the shop, it's only for a milk and a bread, or, you know, a little treat, but it's not a need. Not having to pay rent or a mortgage has been massive. Like, all of that money that we used to spend on a mortgage
goes back to our kids.
So this, Craig, is my mum's greenhouse. She spends a lot of time in here planting. It's where she teaches our babies how to plant.
Bit of work putting this together, eh?
Oh, absolutely. They've done a good job with it. What they've done was put the raised gardens in first, and then put the frame on top of it to raise it higher. Last year, this was all tomatoes. So we had beefsteak tomatoes everywhere, and we preserved all of that for like our tomato sauces and all of that stuff. And now she's got all the summer veggies in here at the moment and ready to plant another garden of tomatoes for this season.
So you're teaching the kids how to do this as well?
Absolutely. Mum spends a lot of time teaching them how to plant and stuff as well. And then obviously up at ours, we teach them again, so.
It is so good that you're teaching the kids how to garden though, eh?
Yeah.
I'm not sure enough young people are being taught that, eh?
I know, it's like it's definitely a skill that we need to install in our babies. Teaching them how to be self-sufficient was our number one goal we wanted to focus on this year, or the last couple of years, just in case, like if no one's around, they know how to grow their own kai, they know how to harvest their own kai and take care of their own kai. You know, when you have kai sovereignty, you're independent, you can do whatever.
Yeah. And the food's better.
It's so tasty. So much tastier, and you know, we don't use chemicals or anything on our food either.
And I think the kids will get a passion for growing their own kai that'll last them for the rest of their lives, eh?
Absolutely, especially fruit trees. We had to plant so many fruit trees because, man, the amount of fruit that they eat, I'd have to be a millionaire. So it's cool growing fruit trees as well, to, you know, just to see them sit under. In another 5 years time or a couple of years time, we're going to see them all sitting under these trees and just picking off their kai.
This is an awful lot of produce you create here. What do you do if you have too much?
So we have five houses we feed, so that's just our whānau houses. So any overflow of our veggies or anything that's going to go to waste, we share it out. So we have friends and stuff, or you know, even the community down here, we'll just put up a post and the community page, and if anyone needs any kai, then we end up dropping it off to them. Or we do drop a lot off to the kai cupboard down in Tokomaru Bay as well. Yeah. What we love most about this lifestyle is the freedom it gives us. We roll on our own time. We do things when we want to do things.
Finish things when we want to finish things.
And most people are at work and we get to go fishing and diving and have beach days with the kids.
So I really like all of the fruit trees, and the part I like about our house is my room, because it looks all naturey and there's vines all over the walls. What I like about doing here is that we play heaps of games here, like go home, stay home, Monopoly, hide and seek.
Capture the flag.
My favourite feature of our place is the bathroom, because I put it up. So this is the bathroom that I helped create with my wife. So we got some materials passed down to us, so we used it to our advantage and built our bathroom.
Yeah, so good job. Flash bathtub. What were you using before this then?
The blue 1000
liter. Oh yeah?
Yeah, yeah. We just got a half cut one in bathing in those, so
done
that for a few months and
then
upgraded slowly.
So you got the washing machine here. What were you running these off before?
We were running them off the generator. It's good, but it's also a pain because of the noise shuts out everything else.
Yeah.
And then also you got to worry about your petrol.
Yeah, now you can run it off the batch kit.
I know. I can't wait.
So what do you do for hot water?
We run our hot water off Infinity.
Oh, yeah.
And for us, it's pretty good. It's doing really well with the hot water.
Yeah, once you've got an indoor shower, it's all the luxury, eh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Especially in the winter.
Yeah.
If anyone's out there that wants to go off-grid, our advice would be to just do it. Like, jump in the deep end like we did. And we had no idea what we were doing. We knew what we wanted to do, and we set our intentions to do what needed to be done, and everything flowed. Like, you know, once your intentions are there, it'll happen. Here's some things that you need to be aware of. Number one, if you have kids, taparu, you're gonna have a million loads of washing. Number two, make sure you have a water source. That's been a huge one for us. Number three, no flushing toilet.
Yep.
Number four would be do the mahi, get the treats. The mahi never stops on this whenua. We're always on the go, go, go. If you want your whenua flourishing, you just have to do the mahi.
Okay guys, just been chatting to Tom. He says you now have power.
All right. Yeah.
thank you, guys.
Oh, awesome. So what's the first thing you're going to do with your power?
The projector!
The projector!
Run the projector.
Well, why don't we get you guys set up with the projector, yeah. Right? Go watch some movies.
Let's go.
Come on, guys, let's go watch movies.
What are we watching, guys?
What are we watching?
Lilo and Stitch.
Turn it on.
Off-grid living for me means I get to live life on my own terms.
No, don't you dare. Don't
hey, we all... No. My baby's going to say, can I care for her, okay? Hey, my name.
Mm-hmm.
You're all right.
E te atoa, ho mai ki e mātou, tō ranga maria, tō aroha, tō kaha, tō maramatanga, wa tēnei rā, amane.
I'm able to do more. Just doing simple things every day.
Well, to me, it's that we have heaps of freedom and we have heaps of room to run around and play games in.
Living off the land has given me the opportunity to live healthier, eat healthier, exercise more. Walking up these hills is not an easy task.
Living off grid has made me think differently. It really does humble yourself.
There's a lot of things that you don't need. A lot of materials that you don't really need to live with.
I'd never go back to on-grid living. No way.
I was going to say, once you go, it's like that saying, once you go black, you can't go back. Or something like that. Once you go grid free, some love. That's what I was just thinking.
It taught us patience.
And if you want something, just build it.
And it's not going to happen overnight. Everything takes time. Off-grid living made us real humble. We realise how much stuff we don't need, especially downsizing from a whole house to a tiny home. You know, if things can't fit in our kids' rooms, well, they gotta go. I don't like clutter. Off-grid living has made us think we don't need all those big buildings and stuff. We just need to be surrounded in nature and healthy kai, and that's all we need. Family. Like, if everybody could experience this way of living, man, our world will be so healthy.
Bye!
Bye! Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Nice.
Yours too!
Yeah.